So, something big just happened. On October 30, Affinity announced that all their apps are now completely free. No subscriptions, no trials, no surprise fees lurking in the shadows. Just free. And Affinity Publisher, it got itself a new name, Affinity Layout. Same powerhouse, just with a fresh patch. Which honestly makes this a perfect time to start learning it. Because now everybody can use it for free, and somebody got to show you how to use it without rage quitting halfway through your work. I'm Martin, and this is your crash course in not losing your mind inside Affinity Layout. The free, full-featured, and slightly unpredictable tool that just made desktop publishing fun again. Before we start dropping fancy fonts and pictures of sandwiches into brochures, we need to understand what we are looking at. Today's mission: explore the interface, find the most important tools, and get comfortable enough that the screen stops looking like a cockpit. When you open Affinity, you land on a welcoming window. It's basically the app asking, so what are we making today? Over here, you have your presets. And if you can't find anything here, just click on this green button here, new, and you have much more options. And even if you can't find anything from here, on the right sidebar, you can put your custom numbers in and you are all done. Right now, just take whatever you like and create document. Up top, we can see our usual menu bar, file, edit, document, text, usual program menu bar. Right under the menu sits toolbar. Think of this as a quick access shelf. You can customize what shows up here later. But small overview, here is a vector, so basically Illustrator. Here's Pixel, what is basically Photoshop, and here is layout, what we are talking about, and it's basically InDesign. Below that is the context toolbar. It changes depends on what you are selected. If you gonna select text tool, here's everything you need to modify your text. Here is pen tool, your pen tool buttons, your image placeholder, and everything else. It's Affinity way of saying, I know what you are trying to do, probably. On the left, you see tool panels. These are your action heroes. Move tool, frame tool, picture tool, shape tool, pen tool. And a few that look scary now, but will make sense later. However, you can hover over it and you see the name of the tool and the shortcut key you have to press. And here, you see this little arrow. This means something is hidden. So just click and hold, and you have much more options. Right now, it's on shape tool and on color picker tool. On the right side panel, you see layers, characters, paragraphs, colors, strokes, transform. You can open and close them under window here. Just click on it, then general, and everything you might need is under here. And if you click on it, let's click on layer, you see it disappears from here, but don't worry, just go back window, general, layer, and it reappears. Same goes for if you accidentally just close it, don't worry, just go to window, text, character. And you can put it back where it was. So everything that you might close accidentally, you can reopen it from under window. You can move them around, you might leave them floating, you can put them on with other tabs, you can do separate sections for them. And if you have set it up like you want, just go Window, Panels, Add Preset, name it however you want. Okay, and now if you make any changes here, what else here, let's close them all. All you have to do now to get back where it was before, go to Window, Panel, whatever you named your preset, and everything is back like it was before. And if you want to change the UI, go to Affinity Settings. On PC it's under Edit, on Mac it's under Affinity Settings. Here go to User Interface here, and here you can change background gray level, artboard background gray level, text contrast, UI brightness, UI contrast, UI font size, and here is tooltip delay. I use high UI contrast because default is a little bit too light for my taste. And background gray level, you can go all the way to black or white, but I like it if it's a little gray. And last but not least, here is a status bar. Here you can see what page you are on, and here are tooltips again. What does this tool that you have chosen does beside the obvious? Okay, let's recap before your coffee gets cold. You know where the menus live, what the toolbars do, how panels behave, and how to switch between dark and light mode without summoning demons. You can now look at the layout without sweating. That's a progress. In next episode, we fix your spelling, your autocorrect, and maybe your relationship with hyphenation. Hit subscribe if you like to learn design software from somebody who also Googles his own shortcuts. I'll see you in video 2, where we teach layout to actually speak your language. Thank you. Bye.